Hey, I'm Joelle, and I am with Blake from Yarn. You guys are our 7th annual IMA alt-country song winners.
Yes, we are.
What originally drew you to submit your music to the IMAs?
Yeah, I was trying to remember the other day, and I'm not really sure. I think I heard about you guys through a friend, and I just thought I'd throw it out there.
So were
it's
you
our
pretty...
first record, so we're
oh.
trying to get along.
Were you pretty shocked when you won?
Yeah, because I forgot I'd even submitted to them, and then all of a sudden I heard about it. It was kind of random because I heard through a friend that we were nominated, and I didn't even actually know we were nominated. And so I was like, cool, very excited.
Do you feel that having an IMA win under your belt has helped your career?
Oh, definitely. I think so. It helps, I think it just helps kind of, you know, trying to think of the word, but give us a little credibility, you know, and other people and people in the industry that have been really successful acknowledge us as winners. It's good to be acknowledged as a winner, you know.
Were you excited about any of the judges?
Yeah, definitely. Snoop Doggy Dogg was a judge, and Ray Davies, the Kinks, one of my favorite bands. So yeah, totally. Cool judges. I saw Tom Waits' this year. I'm a little bummed we didn't have anything to submit because he's definitely a hero.
What would you say to bands out there who are thinking about submitting to the IMAs but they're not totally sold yet?
Do it. You'll be huge. Just like me.
What are some of the challenges that you think independent bands face today?
You know, just... it's a financial challenge, really, because to get your music out there like labels have done in the past, you have to have a lot of money to pay for, you know, your publicist, your radio promoter, all that stuff. But, you know, at the same time, there's a lot of advantages. You know, you can make a record real easily without a label now and get it out there and distribute it nationally and internationally with the internet and iTunes. So, you know, you take the good with the bad.
Do you have a major label goal in mind, or do you want to stay indie?
It all depends, you know. I would stay indie if we could get over this. You know, we're touring all the time now, constantly. And if we could kind of get to a point where we're past the hump and we're filling the rooms as opposed to half filling the rooms, then I would stay indie because you keep all your money. But I think if an offer came about to sign a deal, we probably would, just to get over that hump. But it'd have to be right. It wouldn't, you know. I don't know about a major label though, because we're looking at doing an independent deal for this new record. So just to help with the publicity and with the radio and with the promotion and all that, and street teams and stuff. So I probably will stay indie for remainder of our career, I would imagine.
Then you can keep submitting to the IMA.
And then, yeah, can you submit with the indie if you're
yes,
an indie label?
Yeah.
So yeah, we'll keep submitting.
So the decision is made.
The decision has been made. We're staying indie, and we're gonna win every year.